Hi guys, my name is Chance Farrell. I work here in Morgan Hill at Specialized in the Suspension Lab. Today we're going to be talking about some of the improvements and updates to the MY21 Epic Brain Shock. The big goal on this one was to improve durability, longer service life, keep riders on their bike more and less in the shop. One of the ways we went about tackling that, we addressed some things here on the seal head. There's actually a double bushing there, a bushing on that side and a bushing on that side. So it gives a much more support for that. Even in the beefier downhill shocks and things like that have less bushing overlap than this does. It's something we started doing. We actually did an update to the previous model shock where we added a bushing with the room that we had, but coming into a complete redesign, we added tons more. We also have a new O-ring seal here, a little bit more robust, and it's also sliding on a new steel shaft. It's a chrome steel, which is actually kind of the best sliding surface you can get as far as surface finish and also strength and resistance to scuffing. So it'll last a lot longer. It's also a little bit smaller in size, which also saves a little bit of weight. So stronger and lighter. Moving on back down to the inertia valve. A lot of the infrastructure here is similar, but the way that the oil flows is completely different. On the old shock, we actually had the IFP, which is the compensator. It was actually a bladder on the old shock. It sat on top of the shock. The old one, the oil had to flow in here through the valving and then actually end up back here before it had gone back around. So it's this constant maze that it had to go through rather than being right in line just like it would like cars on a freeway. It wasn't the most efficient design for fluid to flow as far as fluid dynamics goes. We really want the fluid to flow over the valves and then end up in the compensator, which is what this one does. So it keeps a very, very straight flow. It goes in here, here's your compensator piston, flows that way, and then on return, it'll flow right back on through. And what that really does is cuts down the turbulent flow. As oil's coming in and hitting edges and having to make turns, it can get kind of confused and turned around, and that can cause lags and damping. Another thing you'll notice, we actually went back to an IFP. You know, early on, we had some issues with IFPs because usually an IFP, one of the problems is they're usually quite large in diameter. And what they have a tendency to do with this walking motion. And they can scuff the sides of the tube there and cause some service issues. So we went to a bladder on the old shock. We did believe that there could be some bleed down issues with the bladder. So to really eliminate any cause of concern of that, we went back to an IFP, but we didn't want to go straight back to where we were. We wanted to take the IFP to another level. So similar to what we did up here on the shaft, we added a double bushing to the IFP. So it takes care of that walking that most IFPs would have problems with. But on top of that, we also made the IFP much, much smaller in diameter. So if you think about a big, big circle, it's very easy for it to be kind of out of balance there as it's going through. So by shrinking it down and making it stroke longer, it's really, really well supported, especially with the double bushing and the reduction in outside diameter. It's very, very straight. It really has no way to walk. We believe it's a good way forward for this. So moving away from the damper side of things, that takes care of the damping control. On the air spring, we saw some changes as well. We've actually gone away from auto sag like we have on a lot of the trail bikes. One of the reasons was we really wanted to open up some different tuning opportunities. Auto sag was a really fantastic way to get your bike set up, but it locked us in with a specific tuning as far as the positive and negative chambers. It had to be in a specific spot for auto sag to work. And we wanted to manipulate that a little bit to get a different ride dynamic. So also getting away from that, we lose a little bit of weight, which is always positive in the cross country world. We're able to move the transfer port around and actually make a little bit larger negative spring. We also add a tuning feature where there's a negative tuning spacer in there. So the consumer at a good shop level can actually manipulate the air spring a little bit. Better air spring performance and more tunability and lighter weight with that.